So for the first one we're using the?
Chain
rule. Okay. So we let u equal what?
X plus 6.
What's another word for what we just did? Substitution. So y now equals 4t to the u squared. Call it out. Do y dx equals? Du dx times?
Dy du.
So can I derive u? Du dx here equals?
1.
Dy du equals? 4 times
two u
times e to the u squared. Very good. Derivative of the power, get the front.
How do you know what to let u equal?
It's the thing inside the brackets.
It's always just going to be units and not with the power.
Yeah. Now, if that wasn't e, so that was 7 to the power of that, you need to use the chain rule twice. If that was, say, 7 to the power of x plus 6 squared, you would need to use the chain rule twice, because you know that to derive that, you just take the derivative down. But if that wasn't the case, you need to do the chain rule. But I won't set that straight up. Just be familiar with the chain rule, then you'll figure it out. Which equals what? 8 u e to the u squared. So in this line here, what do we write?
dy dx
equals?
1
8
u e to the u.
So 8 u e u squared. I could write 1 times, but I don't need to. Now what do? So I'd write let u equal x plus 6 to y dx equals 8 x plus 6 e to the x plus 6 squared. Very good. Most of us get that or get some A plus. Question 2, what are we thinking for 2? What's the rule we're thinking of using here? Frank's rule? So Frank's rule is? What's my Frank's rule? Dy dx equals?
Fx. G dash x.
Fx. G dash x plus gx f dash x, doesn't matter what order. Anyone see anything that might be problematic?
The chain.
I'll let you think. Let you think on it for a sec. A couple of things that are tricky about it. My advice is always, so once you've written your rule out, write out what fx is. What's fx?
x
plus 9 squared. What's gx? Yeah, very good. I like that you've represented that as x to the power of a half. Just get rid of that square root straight away. Put it in the term that you're happy with.